The move to restore the river sources and control further destruction of the wetlands along the riverway is a huge option to protect water sources. The project, funded by the Global Environmental Facility from the Least Developed Countries Fund to the tune of $4,350,000, has seen buffer zone marking for the rivers named by Jimmy Pule, the project manager.
Now, if we can destroy the river to the very source, and yet downstream, 10 kilometers away, people are depending on this river anyhow as drinking water. In Narua town, the main source of drinking water is River Enyau. But from the source, River Enyau is not there. So we are saying, can we restore it so that we have River Enyau back working?
The project started in 2021 and will end in December 2025. By the time it started, already more than 1 year was lost.
Government of Uganda, through the Department of Wetlands Management Department and Directorate and Department of Environment and Social Services Sector Support and Department of Forestry and Social Sector Support, had already bought concrete pillars which are used for demarcation. So these departments contributed the pillars that we used to demarcate the rivers and the ecosystems that we have made the demarcation.
The Assistant Commissioner, Department of Environment Sector, Support Ministry of Water and Environment, Maureen Anino, in an interview after a 2 days engagement with the officials in Arua on Thursday and Friday, said the purpose of the engagement is to enhance dissemination of the weather and climate outlook for Arua district and city for the months of November and December.
As you may be aware, we are experiencing weather surges as observed from the extreme events that we are currently witnessing countrywide, and all these have contributed to the loss of lives, loss of livelihoods, destruction of property, but it has also led to the increase in diseases and pests, as well as destruction of critical infrastructure that we need.
Redempta Turehohabwe is a meteorologist from Uganda National Meteorological Authority and explained the climatic changes resulting from the destruction of nature.
And this is due to the industrialization that is taking place. People have done tree cutting, we no longer have swamps, we no longer have wetlands. So all those, they have led to the decline of our rainfall, even the temperatures to keep on what. So maybe what I can advise is there's what we call adaptation. You learn to live with what is happening. You learn to adapt.
She advises farmers to do early planning due to rain variation in West Nile districts.
What I can encourage farmers is to plan early, since you already know that your area receives that type of what? Climate.
Arua LC5 Chairman Alfred Okwonzi asks Ministry of Water and Environment to ensure alternative livelihood is provided for the people affected by water restoration along River Enyau.
Now the buffer zone in Arua district with the border with the city up to the source of the Nile was done, up to the source of Enyau River Valley was done. Now what is remaining is for ministry to swing into action very, very fast and make people have their alternative source of livelihood.
River Enyau remains the main source of water that supplies Arua district and Arua city, but has been heavily split by farmers and people who build closer to the water area despite the buffer zone marking. Report compiled by Robert Ariaka for the news.